met with a guy for coffee a couple of weeks ago, and in the very beginning of the conversation, he said, man, I'm just having a hard time figuring out what I'm passionate about. 15 minutes later in the conversation, he tells me that he's created a blog, created a website where he's going to help people figure out what they're passionate about.
You're going to do what? Every time a Forex trader spams the comments of your post, an angel loses their wings. The only thing this dude knows about Forex is probably his shirt size because he lives in his mom's basement.
I think that the very beginning of what you just said, when he told you for 30 days to think and pray and meditate on it, I think the majority of people out there that are trying to figure out, like, what am I passionate about, trying to figure out what are my gifts, trying to figure out what I'm supposed to be doing, they give it like 30 minutes, you know, and then they get frustrated after 30 minutes that they didn't figure it out, and they move on to the next thing, and they're in this constant state of, I don't know what to do, but they're not really trying to do anything. And you spent that 30 days trying to figure it out, and the cream rose to the top, and it makes sense that you were so intensely focused and you figured it out, when most people just aren't willing to put the work in to figure out what it is that they want to put the work in to. Literally, I think that's what it is. Like, go try it. Like cooking, go try cooking. Mm-hmm. Go try art, go try this, like try all these different things.
But it's such a difficult, especially when you're on a sales podcast, you're talking to people that are a lot in sales, yeah, as a profession, and that they don't feel that that may be their purpose. But there's, you can find purpose in what you can do with the rewards of doing good work, right? Yep.
Are you chasing hustle, or are you chasing, then I thought he was gonna say passion, like, are you chasing passion? But he said, are you chasing your gifts? And so the importance, right, is chasing your gifts, not your passion, because you can become passionate about something, or you can lose passion in something, no different from a relationship to a job or a career. But your gifts are your gifts, and looking at what you're actually talented, like, what are those things that you can do easily that other people, it takes them forever to do? And, you know, I'm super passionate about football. Okay, yeah. Okay, great. Like, do you have any talent? No. Well, but I'm passionate about it. Okay, great. Well, you can become passionate about anything. And so that's, you know, when you're going all in on the thing that you were actually, like, the skill and talent and ability that you were actually born with, to me, there's something special that happens there. A lot of people, I call that congruence, that when you're operating out of those natural skills and abilities, you will become passionate in that situation.
I'm trying to think of a way to say, like, what if the means to an end was the end? Like, what if, because so many people, like, in their career, they don't even look at a career like their job. They're like, oh, it's just a means to an end. But, like, what if that's the whole purpose of life, is, like, the means is the end. Like, the means is, it's everything.
And it's like, what if the means are the end? It's like, what if the entire journey is trying to figure out what you're supposed to be doing in life? And not looking at it as with such short-term vision, and, like, in 2019, I will figure out what I'm supposed to do with my life. But figure out that, like, what if life is figuring out what you're supposed to do with your life?